I mean, windows are what, the eyes to the world and the pains in our asses. So, but I mean, they're letting, you know, the goal is on a site like this, you buy, these clients bought this lot for the views. And one of the first things you learn through the passive house trainings is you don't sacrifice the lot and the views just so you can have a well insulated wall. Like if you've got views of mountains, then you go for the views of the mountains and you build the rest of the house around that. So so the windows here were giving us the views primarily, and also daylighting, which we're not getting too much of the daylight now because our light's being absorbed by the concrete and the plywood that we still have exposed. But once we have our finishes in there and light's gonna bounce off our floors and bounce off our plastered walls and our tile centerpiece there, we'll really feel that effect of the daylighting. Oftentimes windows seem to just be thought of as needing to be operational. And an operational window is gonna have a lower performance than a big, huge, fixed piece of glass. So we have 9 window units in this house, and we only have 1, 2, 3, 4 operating 5 units. So we have a lot of fixed glass in this house that's giving them the views and the daylight that's really important to them. And we have just a few operating units to give them the ventilation that they need. We also have a 15-foot wide, 9-foot tall folding accordion door that's gonna give them plenty of ventilation. So, okay, so as we were just talking about the differences between fixed and operational units and why we've used a lot of fixed windows in this house and not very many operational units, but we've also used combos. So this is a really important spot for us to have glass. They are going to have a really beautiful garden right outside this window, but this is also a good spot for us to have ventilation. It's on the north side of the house, and it's also their laundry room. So this larger unit here is a fixed pane of glass, and then we just have a small operational unit. And if you tilt it in, so it can be open for ventilation, and then you can close it, and the whole thing can be opened fully over the top of the laundry room countertop. So the difference between these windows and say a conventional or a code minimum window, and why we use them. Well, we've found just through the energy modeling that we do that even if you weren't building to a passive house standard and you were just building to a code standard, the three kind of pillars that would make the biggest difference would be air sealing, exterior insulation, and then also better windows. So right now, California code minimum U value, U factor is 0.30, and we're at 0.17 on these windows. So we're about twice as good. So that's about an R, R5, R6 for our windows. Just by using better windows, it makes a gigantic difference in the total performance of the house. These are Zola windows. They're made in Poland. There are American companies making triple pane windows that are really good windows, and we will probably use some of those companies on our next projects. I really like these windows a lot, but I'm not beholden to any one manufacturer. Passive house really does come down to the details. We talk about it in the big picture scheme of things a lot, and the big effects that it could have on the planet, on people's comfort, on your habitants' health, the occupants of the home. That's all great big macro stuff and big picture stuff, but it really does come down to the little details of the hands that put it into the opening and then and tape it off. So the details are really important. The manufacturing, you know, on-site manufacturing of taped corners so that they fit just right into all four corners, and then putting your 3-inch tape, wrapping it behind the aluminum rain screen and tucking it in, and then sealing it to our liquid air barrier, which is also acting as a primer for the tape. All of those little details make the big difference in how they get installed, how they operate, how they work, how they function, how they perform. So that's our air sealing envelope. And then the actual operating windows themselves, fortunately, they come out pretty square. straight out of these factories. But if you were trying to do this with a typical American window, the chances of your window sealing on all four sides perfectly, it's that sound, that kind of like shh. Like you can hear that like instantly with these windows. There's a lot of finagling that you'd have to do to get that right in a typical American window. And it often will, you might get 90% of it, but that last 10% that's not working means your window's ineffective. So the little details of how we installed this one or all of these windows, that kind of makes the big difference. It creates our air seal. It gives us that little room to a backing to pack our insulation in there and stop that thermal bridge in between the window and the frame. Yeah.